Right now I'm researching a very specific type of magnetic semiconductor. Spintronics is essentially the marriage of magnetic and semiconductor materials. And we're good. Nice and round. So it's essentially one material which incorporates both functionalities.
The advantage of a spintronic conductor versus a regular semiconductor is that you can maintain the orientation of the electron spin. In a normal semiconductor, you cannot maintain the orientation of the spin, which means that any information encoded on the spin orientation will be lost during the electron transport.
The ferromagnetic phase is what allows you to see the spin, and it allows it to essentially stay polarized. If you have something that is paramagnetic, for example, once you turn off the magnetic field, it's gone. And that's not what you want. Spintronic materials can help us stay on the Moore's path, the Moore's law. So Moore's law states that every couple months, you double the number of transistors on a single chip. But there's an issue. In order to double the number of transistors on a chip, you have to make them smaller and smaller, because you have to cram them in all on the same chip. Spintronic materials would combine the logic, storage, and communication capabilities that are currently separated, and it would combine them onto one chip. The holy grail, I would say, of spintronics is quantum computing. Create new chips to make quantum computing a reality. One of the reasons why it's been so hard to make a spintronic material is because solids aren't liquids. They have specific positions in a crystal, and it's hard to get them to mix exactly the way you want.
I mean, let's say you have initially two chairs in a room and you have three people, then it's basically difficult to sit each person on one chair, right? So in this case, for example, the people represent the atoms. If you can add a third independent chair, then you should be able to sit all three in a much more ordered fashion.
What our research allows us to do is by decoupling the effective lattices, the magnetic lattice and the semiconducting lattice, we can dope and substitute either one independently of the other. It's a more systematic approach to studying the fundamental physics.
As a chemist, I think about creating brand new structures that are not known by anybody so far.
In our lab, we're all over-glorified bakers. A baker, they do different things, right? To make the bread, the final product, have a certain consistency. That's essentially what we do, only we kind of change the atoms in it.
These particles have spikes on their surface. We call them hedgehog particles. The presence of these spikes changes a lot of properties.